Welcome back to the course of ICT for IES 2019. So far we have discussed four chapters of the syllabus, and in this video we are going to start with the next one, that is technology based education. The fact is educational field has been enhanced because of ICT at a very large extent, we can say, because there were so less people who were able to take the education because of the distance. And there were so many factors that were responsible for people not being able to take the education. But the technology-based education is like something magic for those people who are not able to go through the place of learning and get their learnings and learn the new things. So on internet nowadays, everything is available. So in this video, we are going to see in this chapter we are going to see what are the new fields, how is it developed, what are the methodologies for that. So let's have an overview of the syllabus quickly for this chapter. So very first we will discuss the introduction, then we'll see what are the objectives of ICT in education. Yes, we must know what are the objectives of ICT in education. Then the continuum of the approach, ICT in schools. Yes, how in school level also there is one subject of ICT. You may know that. So we'll get to know what they cover into this. And ICT enabled teaching learning process, ICT for open and distance learning, ICT for school management information system, tools used for ICT in education, ICT in India, government initiative, what are the government initiatives that have been taken so far, advantages of ICT in education, and the limitations of ICT in education. Yes, we must know what are the limitations of ICT in education. Since knowing only advantages is not been happening so far. So let's go through the introduction of ICT based education. So technology based education is an integration of instructional technology into learning environment of schools. Yes, the teaching learning environment is something like the schools are being developed. This is a two-sided approach. Like in schools you are using ICT, this is one thing, and the other thing is like though you cannot reach to schools, you are getting the knowledge because of ICT. This is another thing. So in this video we are going to see the how schools are developing based on using the ICT, that is technology. So it refers to the educational settings that apply advanced technologies such as computer and internet in the process of teaching learning. It aims to equip learners with appropriate social skills required to cooperate with the fellow ICT learners for more productive learning experience. This facilitates good communication between student and thus promoting better social understanding. Yes. So let's go through see what are the objectives of ICT in education. So the very first objective of ICT in education is expanding access to all level of education. In most of the developing countries, full-time study within the time constraint of classroom is not really accessible to all the people. For many who wish to learn will have to take place at the time and location for their choices. The barriers such as time, distance, yes, this is one of the most important things, that the time factor, the distance factor comes between the people, the person and his education. So at the same time, rapid changes taking place in workplaces will require training to be delivered quickly. Yes, nowadays technology is getting very fast, and for example, you are working for some industry and you need to take up the whatever the new technology is very quickly. For such thing you need training, and it must be very high speed and as well as low cost, and it should be capable of reaching small and large groups. As policy consideration, the application of ICT to enhance access to learning must receive the highest priority. ICT in their many forms have been applied in variety of contexts. So reaching learners in remote communities, taking education to girls. Yes, this is one of the most serious problem in our India, we can say. So yet so many girls were not able to reach out and take their education. But ICT is one of the promising thing that is making it possible for girls to take education. Next is providing learning opportunities for individual in challenged circumstances, providing education for out of school youth, and creating open and virtual learning environments. So this was about expanding access to all level of education. So next objective is to improve the quality of education. Yes, the quality of education, we can say, so far in the schools, if it is not like they don't know, but there are some limitations. Like when you go through books only, you are not that much accessible to all the new things, new technologies that are coming so far. So ICT helps in improving the quality of education. One of the most powerful reasons for using ICT in educational system is that it puts learning in hands of user. Yes, the users, the students, they themselves can learn so many things. There is the open access to all the new technologies, we can say, or education is there. So students by themselves can take whatever they want to. So ICT also promotes active learning. Yes, active learning. This is one of the most important thing, and allows for interaction between and among peers and mentors. Many would say that as well as quality and effectiveness of learning is enhanced many times because of the use of ICT. So what are the five objectives that define improvement quality of educations? So it is curriculum enrichment, flexibility. Yes, the because of ICT, it has been very flexible for students to learn according to their time and their distance factor. And transformation in learning and teaching process, professional development of teachers. Yes, teachers are also being very we can say advanced because of use of ICT in education. And resource sharing, yes. We can say that the use of ICT is like something really very very important, because you can share your resources, such as practically we can see that if there is a book and you are not able to share that book amongst many people at a time, but because of ICT you can share the PDF, we can say, and there are so many file formats in which you can share the book to all the people, and you can many of them can use or access to the same resource at a time. So this has been very important thing and has helped in education a lot. So next is enhancing lifelong learning. So lifelong learning is necessity in the world that changes and renews itself so rapidly. This dynamism makes demands on individual to upgrade themselves constantly in the context of their workplaces, social life, and participation in healthy and vibrant democracies. Two broad categories of individual use the lifelong learning opportunity. The first group is who are underrepresented across the whole range of post-basic education, and it includes includes among others illiterate and new literate population in engaged in unskilled work, ethnic, and there are so minority groups and people with learning difficulties and physically challenged. So yes, there are so many people who are not able to have access to the things that a normal person can. For example, there are so many physically challenged people. For them as well, for example, you might have heard about the girl, IAS aspirant girl. She was handicapped, so she used to take she used to listen to the textbooks. The technology hasn't so advanced that all the books are available in the audio format, and you can get access to it very easily. So this is the next step to like commercial, or we can say a common educational method. So the second group refers to those who have had benefit of some form of post basic education but are not equipped with deal efficiency with the technology driven environment. And yes, you might have the basic study of whatever the course you have done, but you might not be very advanced in the technology. So you can make use of ICT for building your new concepts. So next is continuous education of workforce. As shift occurs in economic activity, so does the need to review the workforce in response. This applies as much to rice farmer as it does not work does to an ICT worker. To maintain and enhance competitive advantage of their workforces, nations are being to give more attention to training and retaining people. Just in time training, for example, the rapid changes taking place in workplace will require training to be delivered very quickly. Such training needs to be high speed, low cost, and accessible to small and large groups. Yes, the training has to be accessible anywhere and at any time. Just in time training is especially relevant in the context of business and industrial training, where it is there is continuous need to respond quickly to demand from work environment. So this was all about that. So next is facilitating non-formal education. So ICT is being used to make information and knowledge available to non-formal concepts. Context. The demand for enrichment learning is on rise, particularly in countries experiencing an increase in aging population. Yes, there are the aging population, for example, the people above 40 or we can say 50. Those are not very used to the internet access or we can say all the new technologies. So the non-formal education considers that. The demand for these are the learners for pleasure. They are not at all concerned with the technology and its use, but they are they study this or learn the new technologies or the funny things just for their fun, just for their enjoyment. So it is all about that. So ICT offers a convenient solution, but if the individual had the skill sets needed to use appliances and navigate through the millions of web pages. Yes, the problem is the senior citizen, if we consider, he should be able to get access to all those things. He should be able to go through the web pages and whatever the information is available on the internet, he should be just able to access all those things. Then it will be very convenient for him or her to make use of that. So let's go, and these were all the objectives that we have discussed so far. So let's see what is the continuum of approaches for ICT based education. So studies of ICT development in both developed and developing countries identify at least four broad approaches through which educational system and individual school proceed in their adoption and use of ICT. So in the figure you can clearly see what are the four broad approaches that are emerging, applying, infusing, and transforming. So we will go through it one by one. So the emerging approach. The schools at beginning stage of ICT development demonstrate the emerging approach. Such schools begin to purchase and have had donated some computing equipment and software. So the initial, very initial stage of anything would be like as far as we are considering the continuum of approach. So it will be the emerging or entering state. So at this state, the schools would have to purchase new softwares, the equipment devices. In this initial phase, the administration and teachers are just starting to explore possibilities and consequences of ICT for school management and adding ICT in curriculum. So as I have already mentioned this thing that the subject of ICT has been included in the syllabus of school students. So this at the emerging stage, the teachers would just introduce what exactly ICT is to the students. So the curriculum reflects an increase in basic skills, but there is awareness of uses of ICT. This curriculum assists movement to next approaches if so desired. So the next step would be the applying approach. The application of something that has been there is very important. So those schools in which new understanding of contribution of ICT to learning has developed, so it has to be taken to the next step. So in the secondary phase, administration and teachers use ICT for tasks already carried out in the school management and the curriculum. So whatever are the things that has been traditionally done, so those things would be taken up by the ICT based technology based methods. So teachers largely dominate the learning environment. So schools at the applying approach phase adapt and curriculum in order to increase the use of ICT in various subjects, whereas to specific tools and the softwares. Yes, this curriculum assists move into next approach if so desired. So what would be the next step of applying approach, application of this approach? It would be influencing. What is the influence of something on something? That is the next, that would be the next step. So at the next stage, the influencing approach involves integrating and embedding ICT across the curriculum and is seen in those schools that now employ a range of computer-based technologies in their labs, classrooms and administrative offices. So teacher explore new ways of in which ICT changes their personal productivity and the professional practices. So curriculum building begins to merge subjects areas to reflect real world applications. So what would be the next step? It will be the transforming approach. So schools that use ICT to rethink and renew school organization in creative ways are transforming approaches. So ICT becomes an integral through invisible part of daily personal productivity. Yes, this has been the integral part of our daily lives as well as the students' daily lives. The focus of curriculum is now learners and learner-centered and integrate subjects area in real-world applications. ICT is taught as separate subject. Yes, it is taught as a separate subject at the school level. Schools have become centers for learning for their communities. So far we have seen different approaches and we have seen what are the objectives of ICT.